Hello, welcome everyone. Hi. My name is Victoria O'Malley. I'm the Director of Events here at the Athenaeum. I just want to say thank you so much to everyone joining us this evening. It is our first event back in this new space, so welcome. And we are so excited that we're able to launch our first event with Castle of Our Skins this evening. This week has been monumentous for us with the reopening of our building after a years-long renovation project. It is so exciting to welcome our members and the community back to finally show off all of the hard work the Athenaeum has done to preserve our historic space, but also expanding into new spaces and offering new experiences. To our members, thank you for your patience and our trust in us. And to those who are new or visiting, if you're curious about membership, please head over to the front desk after the show. We will be having a reception in the new Leventhal space, which is right beyond the Bow Room. And I encourage you to take a look around the first floor. We have all these wonderful new paintings and sculptures around, and we're so thankful to have you here tonight. Without further ado.
More thanks. Hello. Lovely to see you all. My name is Ashley Gordon. I, as you can imagine, play viola. I'm also a co-founder and lucky to have my fellow co-founder in maybe 15, 20 minutes here with us, Anthony R. Green. We, 10 seasons ago, started Castle of Our Skins. And so this is our 10th season celebration, and we thought it would be appropriate to revamp the very first program we ever did, which is this, Love Affects. And this program, in terms of a concept, is the same, but it's very much revived in consort with our Shirley Graham Du Bois creative in residence, Angel C. Dye, who you'll hear from. Poet helped sort and curate the poetry that you'll hear. So music and poetry, all exploring the ideas of love and how love influences our relationship with ourselves, our responsibility to future, our understanding of past, and how we engage with community. On the tables out front, you may have passed a QR code for a digital program book. What you have in your hands is probably better since it's larger, but the QR code for the digital program book has information about all of the artists. You're able to read all the beautiful poems that were curated, including one of which is from Angel here. Also on that table, you can see the first program from Love Affects way back when, if you're curious. We have something called Love Tank, which hopefully some of you may have already engaged with, a little bit of an activity. Give one, take one. So take a love affirmation, take an envelope, and be surprised with what's inside, hopefully pleasantly surprised. And then also give a love affirmation to another audience member. So feel free to engage freely with that. Would love to connect with all of you. I'll maybe speak, hopefully, on behalf of all of the artists at the reception, so please do stick around. And I hope you enjoy Love Affects. Thank you so much.
Love and me. Love and we. Love and then. Love and next. Love and. Love and. Love and. And love. And always there is love. The force you, I, we can't always name, but always know. Can't always touch, but wanna go in its direction, its path, its honor and joy and kiss and laugh. And love. Love and me.
Oh!
celebrate with me what I have shaped into a kind of life. I had no model. Born in Babylon, both non-white and woman, what did I see to be except myself? I made it up. Here on this bridge between starshine and clay, my one hand holding tight my other hand. Come, celebrate with me that every day something has tried to kill me and has failed.
Thank you.
Love and we. Love and us. Love and every person on this planet, plane, galaxy, cosmos. Love is because we are, because you are. But you and I and all of us have an open chain link that can only lock onto other living things, living beings. Living and loving belong together, the same as love and we. I've been thinking about love again. Those who live to have it, and those who live to give it. Of course, there are those for whom both are true, but never in the same measure. Those who have it to give are like cardinals in the snow, so easy and beautifully lit. Some are rabbits, hard to see except for those who would prey upon them, all that softness and quaking and blood. Those who want it cannot be satisfied, eagle-eyed and such talons. Any furred thing will do. I wander out into the winter. I know what I am. Thank you.
Thank you.
Now, then, always. In this moment, it is difficult to imagine a place safe enough for shedding shell and stone. A place where brick walls and firm borders fall away. In this moment, marked by barriers and blockades, shields over eyes, mouths, face, it's hard to hope for transparency or transparently. Every corner is cracked, every alleyway edged. Traversing means traveling barefoot on sharp camouflaged shards, shouting into voids that boom back echoes of certain anxieties, uncertainty. Scab and wound knit the only covering tailor-made to these temples. Scars demand a healing process that is a luxury too lengthy. So we calcify, cement ourselves to the heaven-high stairway even as we climb, become one with edifices erected to efface us. We poem, preach, pray, sing the only songs we've ever known. Accept this moment not as isolated situation, but rather evidence of generations who made it here, rowing the rivers of our veins, and we press on.
Thank you.
Quilting. From a letter written to W.E.B. Du Bois by Alvin Borquest of Clark University in Massachusetts and dated April 3rd, 1905. We are pursuing an investigation here on the subject of crying as an expression of the emotions and should like very much to learn about its peculiarities among the colored people. We have been referred to you as a person competent to give us information on the subject. We desire especially to know about the following salient aspects. One, whether the Negro sheds tears. Reply, he do, she do. They live, they love, they try, they tire, they flee, they flight, they bleed, they break, they moan, they mourn, they weep, they die, they do, they do, they do. Thank you. touched by an angel. I realize the pun in this. We, unaccustomed to courage, exiles from delight, live coiled in shells of loneliness until love leaves its high holy temple and comes into our sight to liberate us into life. Love arrives, and in its train come ecstasies, old memories of pleasure, ancient histories of pain. Yet, if we are bold, love strikes away the chains of fear from our souls. We are weaned from our timidity. In the flush of love's light, we dare be brave. And suddenly we see that love costs all we are and will ever be. Yet, it is only love which sets us free. And aren't we all just trying to get free and stay there? Change ourselves, change our world, change the love we have into something that frees everybody? Love's greatest affect is its malleability, that it can conform into any shape or space where it is needed for you and me and we. If love affects everything, then why shouldn't we give ourselves, our world, our past, present, future, over to it freely? All that you touch, you change, Octavia Butler professed. All that you change, changes you. The only lasting truth is change. Thank you.